Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hello, how are you? How's it going? I am good, and you? I'm Amin, and welcome to Learn Arabic with Amin. Welcome to Palestinian Jordanian Dialect Sentences Playlist. I will give you some sentences in Jordanian and Palestinian dialect, and I will explain them to you one by one. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and check all the playlists and all the dialects, because I have all the dialects in my channel. So now let's start. These are our sentences for today. As I said before, I will explain it to you one by one. First sentence is روح على البيت. روح على البيت. روح, it means go. It's an order tense when you are talking to a male. روح, go. روح على البيت. ع is to. البيت is the home or the house. على البيت, to home. To home or to the home. But together, روح على البيت is go home. روح على البيت, go home. Next sentence is حضر عشاء للضيوف. حضر عشاء للضيوف. حضر عشاء للضيوف. حضر, it means prepare. It's a command order tense when you are talking to a male. حضر, prepare. عشاء, it means dinner. عشاء, dinner in Palestinian Jordanian dialect. للضيوف, للضيوف. لا, لا is for, for. لا is for. الضيوف, الضيوف is the guests, the guests. الضيوف, the guests. الضيف, the guest. الضيوف, the guests, plural. حضر عشاء للضيوف. Prepare dinner for the guests. حضر عشاء للضيوف. Prepare dinner for the guests. Next sentence is العشاء جاهز. العشاء جاهز. العشاء جاهز. As I said before, عشاء means dinner. العشاء, the dinner. ال is the. العشاء, the dinner. جاهز, it means ready. It's an adjective for male. جاهز is ready for male. العشاء جاهز, it means the dinner is ready. العشاء جاهز, the dinner is ready. Next sentence has a small difference here. العشاء صار جاهز. العشاء صار جاهز. العشاء صار جاهز. العشاء, the dinner, as I said. صار, صار means became. It's past tense verb for male when you're talking about male thing. العشاء is a male, okay? صار is became, past tense. جاهز, as I said, ready. So العشاء صار جاهز means the dinner became ready. العشاء صار جاهز, the dinner became ready. ما لقيت شيء. ما لقيت شيء. ما لقيت شيء. Some people say this sentence, ما لقيت شيء. ما لقيت شيء. So لقيت or لقيت. لقيت or لقيت, no problem, you can use any one of them. ما لقيت شيء. ما is a negative tool. It makes the verb after it negative. It's like not. لقيت, I found. I found, past tense. لقيت, I found. شيء. شيء, it means thing. Thing, okay? شيء, thing. ما لقيت شيء together means I haven't found anything. ما لقيت شيء, I haven't found anything. And as I said, you can say this sentence, ما لقيت شيء. Next sentence is اعمل لي فنجان قهوة. اعمل لي فنجان قهوة or قهوة. قهوة or قهوة in Jordanian Palestinian dialect. قهوة or قهوة means coffee. اعمل لي فنجان قهوة. اعمل it means prepare or make. Mostly it's the same use of حضر. Okay. اعمل, make or prepare. When you are talking to a male, it's a common tense. اعمل لي فنجان قهوة. لي for me. لي means for me. فنجان cup. قهوة or قهوة is coffee. So the sentence is اعمل لي فنجان قهوة. Make a cup of coffee for me. اعمل لي فنجان قهوة. Make a cup of coffee for me. Next sentence is مش راح اسافر. مش راح اسافر. مش راح اسافر. مش is not. Negative tool also. راح it means will. So مش not, راح will. أسافر I travel. أسافر I travel. If you are talking about yourself, I travel. I travel. أسافر. مش راح أسافر. مش راح أسافر. I will not travel. مش راح أسافر. I will not travel. أجا ولا لسه. أجا ولا لسه. أجا ولا لسه. أجا it means he came. He came. ولا it means or. ولا is or. لسه not yet. أجا ولا لسه means did he come or not yet. أجا ولا لسه did he come or not yet. Next sentence is أعطيه إلو. أعطيه إلو. أعطيه إلو. أعطيه it means give him. Give him. أعطيه together. Give him. إلو for him. أعطيه give him. إلو for him. The English meaning is totally different. Give it to him. Give it to him. أعطيه إلو. Give it to him. أعطيه إلو. If the object is a male. Okay. If the object it is a male. أعطيه إلو. Give it to him. Last sentence for today is شو المشكلة or شو المشكلة. شو المشكلة or شو المشكلة. شو is what. المشكلة or المشكلة is problem. The problem. Because ال here. المشكلة or المشكلة the problem. شو is what. So the sentence is شو المشكلة. It means what is the problem. What is the problem. شو المشكلة or شو المشكلة. What is the problem. So these are our sentences for today. I hope that you enjoyed them and you learned new things. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, like and follow my Facebook page. And don't forget to check all the playlists and all the dialects, because I have all Arabic dialects in my channel. And I have also Fusha Standard Arabic. And I upload 2 videos every day. So don't forget to stay tuned with me. So see you tomorrow with a new video and new lesson. See you tomorrow. Salam. Peace.